Hello everyone, this is Dave, and this video is entitled Can It Happen There? And this is a discussion of if the horror that happened to me at Objectum-Sexuality Internationale can happen to another subculture or a person at another subculture. And I'm not going to do a lot of retakes on this video. I'm not going to do a lot of anything with this video because I just want to make sure this video happens. So I may be pausing this video periodically, but other than that, I'm going to try to get through this in one straight shot. And if we think of anything else, there'll be more videos later. Okay, so I want to talk about some of the... I want to talk about... I think if you're going to ask if this can happen to another subculture, I think you have to consider that what happened to me at OSI was a perfect storm, in terms of a lot of factors had to come together to make one terrible thing happen to one otherwise good person. Okay, the problem with Objectum-Sexuality Internationale is they had a corrupt leader. Now, so how does a organization get to have a corrupt leader? Well, for somebody to be corrupt, there has to be a motive. So I think that in the corrupt motive in the case of OSI was that this was an up-and-coming cause, and because this was an up-and-coming cause, there were media opportunities, and you know, if you can get on TV a lot now, then you can get a lot of money and fame from this later. So, book deals, whatever. So, this kind of opportunity can turn maybe an even otherwise good person into a corrupt person, thinking that they're going to be in the spotlight a lot and they're going to become famous from this. But this can only happen in a situation where there's something press worthy. If you want to talk about, say, a furry culture, otherkin culture, stuff like medieval reenactment, the sci-fi culture, whatever, these cultures are already established. There is no new press on, for the most part, on these cultures. So it's not like anybody in these cultures right now is going to suddenly be able to get a lot of media press and attention directed at themselves as a result of anything they're doing with these cultures. So these cultures are pretty safe from the one factor of a leader trying to use them for their own selfish media coverage or whatever. Okay, another factor here is how blindly leadable are the members of a particular subculture likely to be. Now, I would say in a subculture where there's a lot of diversity that this is not going to be the case, because people are not basing their decisions on exactly the same set of rules in a diverse culture. I would say that in, say, medieval reenactment culture, furry culture, sci-fi culture, I would say that there's all types of people. It's not like you're only having autism people or Asperger's people, If, for example, you could prove that autism and Asperger's people are very blindly leadable, and I think there should be studies done on this, because I have a brother who has Asperger's, and this guy literally he hunts for new rules and laws to follow, and then he follows them no matter how illogical or how irrational they seem to be. And so, if this were to be true of Asperger's people, and all of OS's tends to be Asperger's and autism people, then yeah, Objectum-Sexuality culture is setting themselves up for this blindly leadable problem. But if you have another subculture where everybody is diverse and you can't say that they all have the same trait, then they're a lot less likely to be victim of this kind of particular factor. Now, another thing is about how I got angry at OSI. That is a direct result of how important a particular cause is to a person. Is the cause in question one that's likely to define the person's entire life? And is this a cause that is likely to define the person's entire life that they can only get in one place? And say, for example, I get kicked out of a science fiction club. First of all, science fiction isn't my entire life, so I'm not going to get that upset about it. And another thing is that there'd be other science fiction clubs I could go to. But in the case of OSI, OS was the most important thing in my life, and there was nowhere else I could go when Erica did her misdeeds to me. So that's why I got angry, because I was cheated out of the only thing that mattered to me, and there was no backup plan. There was nowhere else to go, and nobody was coming to my aid. So Yeah, that's a factor. If the fa that's a factor. If how important the cause is to somebody and how irreplaceable the cause is to somebody. And the last factor I want to talk about is how damaged are the prospective members who arrive there likely to be? Well, when you're talking about an alternate sexuality, all of us have all sorts of problems. So yeah, you're going to have people arriving at OSI or any alternate sexuality organization that have been beat up by society just like I was, and we're not going to be perfect people, so we're more likely to make mistakes. So this is another factor in the perfect storm that happened between me and OSI. I think to conclude this video, what I'm saying here is that this, what happened to me, can happen to people in other subcultures, but I think that, as I said, this was a perfect storm, and I think that some subcultures are going to be more likely to have these kind of problems than others. So I'm going to conclude this video on that note.